Hello and welcome, and what an intriguing afternoon. It's frame one, 17 frame final, and our commentators Angus McAnally and Mark Wildman.
So the 1989 Irish Masters snooker final is underway. This young, brilliant player, Stephen Hendry, breaking off, 20 years of age, and a man exactly twice that age, Alex Higgins.
And I should imagine that Alex Higgins plans to keep this game as tight as possible. Restricting any potting chances to an absolute minimum. That's been the feature of his game to the final this week. And it was noticeable that even when Stephen Hendry was playing Steve Davis, he wanted to force the pace, so it will pay him to open the game up.
Five. Six.
So pink to the green pocket to hold for one of these three reds. Well, the pink spot appears to be occupied, so referee John Street putting it as close as he can to its own spot in a direct line up from the black spot, without touching another ball. And it really is remarkable to watch just how gently this man strokes the balls.
Twenty-one.
You can break the reds up here, still stay on the loose red.
Twenty-two.
a little bit too much action into the white ball.
28. Stephen Hendricks.
Well, that looks promising. 28 points there from virtually a safety shot from Alex Higgins.
One, Stephen Hendricks.
Very nice judgment of pace there from Alex, but he has left this red to the left-hand centre pocket.
One.
And we may see Stephen back in business here again.
Seven. Fifteen, Stephen Hendricks.
Should Alex take this red on? It would certainly be a confidence tester, but he doesn't appear to be doing so. 15. Well, in fact, he had a go, but he may pay a price for that because Stephen has a red into the green pocket now. Already 44 points ahead in this opening frame.
Thank you, gentlemen.
So, Stephen there taking the more difficult red into the corner pocket rather than the one that Angus had suggested, and missing it, and setting Alex up with an easy red for starters.
One. 7.
I think that Alex could well go back for the blue here. Psychologically, it's absolutely imperative, really, that he knocks in a reasonable score from this first real leaf, just to show Stephen Hendry that he's quite able to do so. And in the end, Alex played for the pink into the left middle pocket and he's run the ball a bit too far.
Eight, Alex Higgins.
So he'll be disappointed with that. Just 8 points. It's quite a nice little leave.
Well, young Stephen showing that he's quite capable of taking his time, working out the options.
Foul. 4, Alex Higgins.
Well, that was a superb shot, really, from Alex. It looked quite a simple shot across the table, but the pressure on it was quite considerable. If he'd have missed it, he could have said goodbye to this first frame. He knew the red had to go in.
7.
Four points behind at this stage and every chance here to retrieve the situation.
14.
And this very similar 21. To the kind of play which took Alex into a 4-0 lead against John Parrott in his semi-final, stroking the ball quite gently.
22. Twenty-nine.
Well, that's another great shot. Needed to get the right angle to get onto the last red. He's got it with this pink. 3-point lead.
35. 36.
And the perfect angle on the black to run down for the yellow. This is the big shot. If he can get nicely on the yellow, he should take the frame.
43.
Well, not hard enough. On the right lines.
'Once again, Alex asking for the cue ball to be cleaned. 11 points ahead in this opening frame. Needing up to and including the brown to put him 20 points ahead at least. But a good safety shot coming up here.
43.
What a great boost it would be to Alex if he could take this opening frame when it looked as if Stephen had it wrapped up. 2, Stephen Hendry. 2. Alex just once again checking the score. 9 points ahead in this opening frame, but realizing now that he needs up to and including the blue to put Stephen in trouble. So he'd be looking for a good safety shot here.
That was classic. Quite some way out with the easy attempted pot green, but the fluke, he won't refuse.
Seven.
2 points in it, so both players need the blue and the pink, two balls. So is the fluked brown going to win Stephen the first frame? Just needs the pink. So young Stephen Hendry from Scotland takes the first frame.
One. Eight.
Well, that first red from Stephen wasn't a particularly good shot. Wanted to be far straighter on the black so that he could get into the bunch of reds, but wasn't able to do that.
Nine.
And that, I would suggest, was a bonus. Well, yet another shot there that was a long way away from where he intended.
Stephen Hendry. One. Rainbow. One, Alex Higgins.
This final, the best of 17 frames, first player to 9, goes through to get the trophy and a prize of £32,500. The unfortunate runner-up gets a mere £20,000.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, quietly.
Well, the crowd getting very excited here as Alex gets yet another chance to win this first frame.
One. Eight.
Alex in good shape here, already with the lead of 19 points. And chance of a few to come.
Nine. Sixteen. 17.
And I thought Alex may have taken the opportunity there to take that red away from the side cushion. But wasn't taking any chances.
Twenty-four.
This black will take him 42 points in front, but still 43 on the table, so he needs another red.
31. 32.
So 43 in front now, colour to come, and then there's only 35 on the table. So pretty safe in this first frame of the evening.
39. Alex Higgins.
Stephen Hendry.
And a
frame. Stephen Hendry conceding that frame. So the first frame of the evening goes to Alex Higgins. It's 5-3 for Hendry. But Alex Higgins wins the next one, frame 9. Only one between them now, 5-4. We move on to frame 10. This sees Alex Higgins establishing a 30-love lead. Hendry, is at the table.
Foul for Alex Higgins.
Now Alex, 34 points in front. Still 8 reds left during this frame.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Well, the first chance that Stephen Hendry's had for quite some time to pot a ball.
One. Six. Seven.
Yeah, looks like a long blow. I wonder what the last half an hour or so has done to his confidence. He's a great 12. Potter, this young man from Scotland. Green causing a few problems there. Eighteen. 19. 26. 27. 34. 35.
40. Stephen Hendry.
Well, just when it looked like this frame might be all over, Stephen Hendry misses a pot that normally he would knock in without too much trouble and finds himself just 6 points in front in this frame. But Alex back in with a great chance.
One. Seven.
All the balls, with the exception of the green, out in the open.
Eight.
Well, a bit straightish on the yellow. Won't be able to do too much about good position on the green.
17.
Alex now 11 points in front. He's going to take on this green into the top corner pocket. He could take the green and brown. Stephen Hendry would then only be able to tie with the blue, pink and black.
17, Alex Higgins.
Well, it looks as if he might have got lucky there. Snooker behind the blue. If it isn't a snooker, there's not very much of the green sticking out.
5. Alex Higgins. Free ball.
And the free ball.
Five points left on the table. He's 16 points ahead, but with the possibility of a free ball. If he decides to, he can increase on the potential 25. Having a free ball, he can't snooker behind the brown.
The situation free. Now is 19 points of difference. If he can knock this green in, Stephen Hendry can then only tie with the brown, blue, pink and black.
Six.
22 points of difference now, 22 points on the table.
Alex Higgins.
Well, there's no way that Stephen Hendry could get back then, and so Alex Higgins, believe it or not, had drawn level at 5-all. You'll remember that he lost the first four frames of the final, so he was down 4-0 at one stage, and now he's got it back to 5-all. Quite a remarkable comeback. We move on now to the next frame in the match, and we rejoin our commentators John Skeen and John Pulman in frame 11. And Higgins is leading 4-0, and he's at the table.
One.
Alex Higgins really on song at the moment.
Four. Five. Five. Alex Higgins, thank you, gentlemen.
And that could be a very expensive mess.
Yes, and no real reason why you should have missed that one, John. It was such an easy stroke.
One. Eight. Nine. Fourteen. Fifteen.
A perfect angle on the blue to get into the pack of reds. We're playing into the pink.
15,
well, you can't legislate for things
Stephen
like that.
Stephen Hendry, five, Alex Higgins. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. One.
This match is turning into something of a test for young Stephen Hendry's character. With that unfortunate foul by Steve Hendry as he broke up the pack of reds.
14.
The advantage has been handed back to Alex. Already in the lead of 13 points.
21.
22. Yes, you've certainly got to hand it to Alex Higgins, John. A little while ago, most people were writing him off. But here he is back, fighting in the final of a major competition.
27.
Certainly no greater trier in the game.
35.
Thirty-four points ahead and an ideal table.
Well, this one isn't easy, but at least he'll be taking the cue ball back to the safety zone. And with that one going in, Stephen Hendry now requires a snooker. 43. Well, if he took two reds and two blacks and all the colours, he could tie. 43 points the difference. I'm sorry, my arithmetic is wrong. 42 points the difference. Needs this brown.
Forty-seven, Alex Higgins.
Players have been saying all week that this is the most enthusiastic audience they encounter in the course of their playing year.
One.
And so, for the very first time...
The long red into the ball pocket.
One.
And that'll help the confidence a little bit. Just a little trickle in now, and there's another red into the top left-hand corner pocket.
Two.
6. Seven. Fourteen.
Stephen Hendry with a splendid chance here of getting back into the match.
15 20. Twenty-one. 26.
Now the black will go into the right-hand corner pocket.
27. 34. 35.
This could develop into a sizable break.
42. 43. 51 58.
This is just what Stephen Hendry needed.
59.
In the last four frames, he's spent very little time at the table. And he needed a good long session like this to restore his confidence.
66. 67.
67. Alec now requiring snookers.
74. 75 82. 83. 90.
91.
Yeah, we'll have to be a bit precise to get onto the last red. Top cushion.
Well, this is classic snooker.
106.
And it's getting the applause from the audience that it deserves.
109. 109.
6-all. What a final this really is turning out to be. Really fantastic stuff. The best of 17 frames, the first to take 9 wins. We join it again now in frame 13. Hendry at the table and he leads by 8 points.
Well, that's a little bit surprising. Young Stephen doesn't usually miss pots like that. A little bit of pressure coming in perhaps.
Six. Seven.
That pink puts Alex 5 points in front.
13.
'Very pleased with that one.
14.
I'll just play a little snooker behind the pink now.
14. Alex Higgins.
No, when he potted the red, he was stretching quite far across the table.
This one is pottable, but it's a thin snick, and it's a dangerous one to take on. Could cost him the frame.
One.
4.
So the tension mounts. Alex Higgins just 2 points in front at this stage.
Thank you, gentlemen. He knows it's his turn.
John Street admonishing the audience in a rather humorous way. Cue Ball had an eventful career there. As left Stephen, I think he has a clear shot on the green.
Five.
3 points ahead.
Stephen Hendry.
Well, looks as if this brown is pottable into the middle, and he's going to be taking him towards the blue. Now, perhaps a chance here for Alex. 3 points behind at the moment. Blue and pink.
Four, Alex Higgins. Five.
Oh, pink required. This is a thin one. And in it goes, and it's Stephen Hendry who goes in front by 1 frame at 7 frames to 6.
What an exciting finish. It's building up to be really absolutely quite remarkable. And we have Stephen Hendry, who led 4-0 when he won the very first four frames this afternoon. And then back came Alex Higgins to take the lead, and now Hendry has taken it back again. Right, let's continue on. We go back to our commentators, John Skeen and John Pullman, as we go to frame 14. There's no score, and Hendry is at the table.
One.
The pink and blue are available, but the black's rather hemmed in at the moment.
Seven. Eight. Thirteen. 14. 19. 20.
Very elegant stance Stephen Hendry has. The back ramrod straight always.
32.
Beautiful action.
37. Forty-three.
Stephen Hendry getting away in this 14th frame. Because if he could win this one, he needs just
43.
One more frame.
Stephen Hendry.
He's built up a 43-point lead.
Well, that was the last thing Alex needed.
One.
And that little knuckle off the center pocket could determine the frame.
6. Seven. 12. 13.
And all of a sudden, young Ian Hendry looks like a man in a bit of a hurry. Quickened up appreciably in this last few moments.
13, Stephen Hendry.
The lead now 56 points, and there's still 67 on the table.
Would have helped Alex greatly if the black were in play.
1.
He did his best to clear the black, and in fact has complicated matters.
7.
Now.
7, Alex Higgins.
Well, Alex really went for broke there. I think that's cost him the frame without any shadow of a doubt. Oh, I don't know.
1.
And the black is on into the middle pocket.
Stephen Hendry.
Well, only 51 points on the table now, so Alex requiring snookers. 2, in fact.
1.
Well, he can take 2 reds and 2 blacks here and then leave a nice snooker behind the pink.
Sixteen, Alex Higgins. Stephen Hendry.
Disappointment there for Alex Higgins, and that put Hendry in frame winning position. 8-6 he leads. That means that Hendry only needs to win one more frame, but Alex Higgins, if he is to come back, can he? He needs to win the remaining 3 frames. Right then, on to frame 15. Higgins leading 9-6, and we join the action with Hendry at the table.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Well, Alex, in a very tough situation here at the moment. Can't afford to lose another frame in this match. But very often it's the man that requires just the one frame from victory that is under a bit of pressure. It's often the most difficult frame of the match to win, the one that takes one over the winning line.
chance for Alex here. Again, he'd be disappointed that the black ball was out of commission.
One. Six. Twelve.
Fairly laborious piece of break building, having to focus all his attention on the pink to the exclusion of the other gunners. And demands inch perfect control of the cue ball.
Twenty. Twenty-seven.
Yeah, it's built up a lead of 30 points now. Still in the driving seat.
Thirty-four. 39. 40.
And this is a very well constructed break.
46. 47.
No, Alex requires this pink and another red to make Stephen Hendry require snookers.
Stephen Hendry acquiring all the remaining reds.
One.
And going the right way about it.
Eight. Nine.
And after he's potted this black, he's going to have to start looking for a couple of snookers.
Sixteen. Sixteen, Stephen Hendry.
Forty-one the lead, only a possible 35 on the table.
So that would seem to have settled the issue of the 15th Three. Frame. Alex now just one frame adrift at 8-7.
Five.
After this, it's a 2-1 situation. Stephen Hendry requiring just one frame to win the championship. Alex requiring the remaining
17.
Two.
really is fascinating stuff, isn't it, with Alex Higgins there fighting to the very end. For those of you who may have joined us late, and just to bring you up to date with exactly what's been happening, Stephen Hendry started off magnificently, leading 4-0 in the afternoon, and at the end of the afternoon session he was leading 5-2. But then Alex Higgins came back to win four frames in a row and go into the lead for the first time, leading 6-5. Hendry then won the next three to lead 8-6. He only needed one more to win the title, but as you saw, Alex Higgins has won one of those frames, so it's 8-7. As we go on now to the very next frame, and we rejoin our commentators, John Skeehan and John Pullman, for the start of frame 16. This time, it's Alex Higgins to break.
About the best final we've ever had in golf's. We go into the 16th frame. 8-7 the score, Stephen Hendry leading.
Six.
Good chance for Alex. A couple of nice loose reds up here near the black spot.
Nineteen. Twenty. Twenty-five.
Well, she established a good 33 points there, but it's come to an end now.
33, Alex Higgins.
One. Eight.
The players like a bit of peace and quiet when they're playing, but it's very hard to blame the audience. It's a very gripping final, this. Alex gone 41 points ahead in this. If he could knock in a few more, it looks as if we're in for a shootout.
Sixteen, Alex Higgins.
Forty-nine points ahead, not enough to win the frame, but a very comfortable cushion.
Ladies and gentlemen, you've been repeatedly asked, please do not shout out. One. Two.
6. Seven.
Stephen Hendry being made to pay a bit for that miss on a fairly simple read into the middle pocket.
Eleven.
Well, Alex, looking at the score, he's 61 points in front at the moment. He needs a colour and one more red. The red Stephen requires snookers.
15.
Still a possible 67 points on the table at the moment. 64 points the difference. So one more red will do.
16.
Well, a tremendous pot there from Stephen, but one feels it's come a little bit late in this frame. He requires two snookers.
Eight. Eight. Stephen Hendry.
Stephen Hendry walks away from the table rather forlornly. Things not going his way at the moment.
Pressure on this last frame. Both players will get very upset if you shout. You're already upsetting them. Let's keep it down, quiet, one frame. Let's all enjoy it. The final frame, Stephen Hendry de Brouck.
The denouement of this long week in golf's reduced to just one frame to decide who's champion. Eight frames each. Stephen Hendry breaks.
Foul for Stephen Hendry.
Well, Alec, in fact, changed his mind on that shot. He was getting down to play the pot at first and then changed his mind to play the safety straight.
One.
Stephen Hendry, who first gets off the mark in this final frame. Virtually playing for £12,500 on this last frame of snooker, the difference between winning and losing.
Didn't break too kindly for him.
Stephen Hendry.
A good shot, but he's left Alex a free run off the right-hand side of the pack. Alex having the ball clean. There's no player who has it clean more often. Absolutely fastidious about it.
Too thick a contact there. I was attempting to get the cue ball back to the ball can. Now, what damage has he done? Certainly the red that's closest to the pink will go into the corner pocket. That would appear to be the first shot. Certainly regret that one. A little bit of pressure coming in. The pockets get smaller and the balls get bigger.
One. Stephen Hendry.
Well, not Stephen's fault that. He got a terrible kick when playing that green. Just like running into a brick wall. But luckily for him, although he missed the green, he doesn't appear to have done too much damage.
Well, this is nail-biting stuff.
One. Eight. Nine. Sixteen. 17.
Hitting the ball with some authority. A lot of loose reds around. Very good opportunity.
'Must be said, John, of course, that Alex Higgins has got that little bit more experience than Stephen Hendry. Although he's been around there now for 3 or 4 years, he hasn't got the experience that Alex has got. And that was a great shot. We haven't had a lot of room to play with that.
21.
Dropped nicely onto the black.
With the pink and blue out of commission, Alex has to alternate between the black and the pork colors.
32.
Twelve-point lead.
33.
'Tis fair to say that the last five reds are all in potable position. And Alex seems to be perfectly placed here. Straight red into the corner, and he's nicely on the black.
36. 43.
So Alex with the best chance he'll ever have to become the Irish Masters champion.
So the lead goes to 26 points now, with just three reds left. Needs this black and another red. Tremendous effort this has been from Alex Higgins. After getting off to rather a bad start in the first session, going 5-2 behind, he looks to be going to be the winner.
55.
Distinct prospect, John, that the crowd are going to invade the pitch.
Alex Higgins. Thank you, gentlemen.
Well, I should think there's every chance of that. He's done enough to win this frame now, I feel.
One.
Sustained applause. No! Stephen Hendry holds out his hand. Alex is the champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you were to write a script for this final here tonight, I put it to you that you could not have written a better one than the way this final has worked out. It's been an absolute classic. Now, we cannot in fairness say that there was a more deserving winner of the Irish Masters final, because anybody who has battled through this week of snooker here and won a final like this would be a deserving winner. But what we can say is, there won't be a more popular winner of the Irish Masters. Alex. Alex. I don't know about you, Alex Higgins, but after that final, I almost have apoplexy. You must be feeling a bit weak yourself.
Well, when I missed the blue earlier on the...
That's it, blame them.
When I missed the blue earlier on, I thought it was good night because Stephen went into a two-frame lead. And I thought my goose was cooked at that particular time. But I went back to the dressing room and a couple of the lads said, keep on battling. And I kept stuck in there and I didn't give up. And it came right at last. It's been a wait, but it was well worth it.
Listen. Tell us. Tell us the truth, Alex. You must tell us the truth. You gave him a four-frame lead to start with. You're doing that to try and make all your fans here nervous.
No, it's just that on this type of table, this is Stephen's type of table. He's actually me in my youth when I used to knock the balls in from.
He's going to be a good one, Alex.
I would love to trade places with him because he's got another 20 years. And and I know the feeling when you have someone like that following you all the time, because I used to do it to Spencer and Raiden. And I'm sure it didn't do anything to their ticker or for their ticker. But Stephen terrifies a lot of players with his excellent potting and his tracking. And his all-round game. I mean, his safety game has improved, and there's a lot of young players emerging. But I like to play Stephen when I get the chance to in practice for fivers and stuff like that. Though, but he's by far, I think, the best player I've seen to emerge.
Well, what a happy Alex Higgins talking to Michael Lester there and paying a deserved tribute to young Stephen Hendry. Right then, just to recap on some of today's sporting headlines, Kilkenny qualified for a national hurling semi-final clash with Tipperary. They beat Cork today in Thurles by 8 points. And Derry City must wait a little longer for that historic Opal League triumph. They lost at the Brandywell to Shamrock Rovers today, while Dundalk won at Inchicore. And in cycling, Sean Kelly and Stephen Roach finished 18th and 30th respectively in the Tour of Flanders, won by the young Belgian Van Heidonk. And that's about it at the end of this very extended sports special. And I'm very glad that you're able to stay with us and enjoy it. We now end with the presentation to the new Benson & Hedges Irish Masters champion. All credit then to Alex Higgins. From us, goodbye.
The Irish Masters final trophy. A cheque for £32,500 to Alex Hurricane Higgins. Ladies and gentlemen, the Irish Masters champion for 1989.